Let's get a local take on this. Adam Fish is working at Lancaster University. He's currently authoring a book called Drone Justice. I spoke with him a little earlier and asked for his thoughts.
No, it does not come as a surprise to me that drone pilots are making the headlines. There's a lot of unscrupulous pilots out there playing around with new technologies. But it also doesn't surprise me that the media is so interested in this topic. For me, it seems like another example of a kind of moral panic that we have about new technologies. At the dawn of the internet in the 1990s, we were very terrified about what the internet was going to do to our brains, what it was going to do to our attention span, what it was going to do to our children. And eventually, when the internet became more pervasive and became part of our life, we gave up a lot of that hysteria. I think the same thing is going to be true with drones. I think we're in a moment of misunderstanding and fear and a bit of hysteria about what drones are. And as soon as they become more well integrated into our society through delivery, through being integrated in business and agriculture and bridge surveying, I think that we'll lose some of this anxiety we have about what drones are and what they can do and how they might hurt us.
Let's try and combat then some of that ignorance. Certainly they've been and proved to be an annoyance.
Are drones a danger? I think you'd be more likely to be saved or have your life prolonged through a drone than to have a drone hurt you, maim you, or kill you. Right now we have drones that are doing search and rescue missions in Switzerland, drones that are delivering blood and medicine in Rwanda. We have drones that are doing surveys for post-disaster relief work. So really, drones are being utilized all around the world for really prolonging life rather than hurting it. Thus far, no one has actually died because of the effect of an over-the-counter drone. In fact, a recent survey says that over 60 people have already been saved by these small drones. So I think you're more likely to have a drone help you than to hurt you.
And it is important, isn't it, to put that counter-argument about how technologies can help us. I just wonder, though, given what you were saying a moment ago about our fear and maybe hysteria about this, do you welcome these increased exclusion zones that the UK government have introduced?
Absolutely. I think exclusion zones, amongst a number of other interventions, are sensible and useful and will certainly need to have them. So, for instance, manufacturers of drones can put a piece of software on that we call a geofencing software, which prohibits users from being able to go into certain areas. And I think that that's going to be a very useful bit of technology. And of course, I think these unique drone guns that can shoot a drone out of the air by jamming the Wi-Fi, I think those are fine. I think these big bazookas.